This is an overview of the Z80-MBC3 computer kit. And I'll show you a little bit about what's in the box. This is the box as you will receive it. It contains a picture of an assembled PCB. And here are all the components that are in the box. And I'll go through them. Of course, you will have a tube with the ICs in it, mainly the larger ones. And there's a bag with all the other components. And in the bottom of the box, you will find also a list with all the components and their values listed. So in the back is not only the PCB to be assembled, but also all the components that are to be fitted on the PCB. And these are, of course, the resistors, all through hole components mainly, and the sockets. And it's important that when you start assembling the PCB, that you first start with the low profile components. That's also shown on the page on Facebook, that you should start with the resistors and gradually step up with the components that have a higher profile. So first the resistors, then you do the capacitors and the sockets, and then you can put on the headers and the LEDs, and finally you do these connectors on the side and also the headers that are fitted on here. And when it's completely finished, and if you finished all the soldering, you can put in the ICs in the sockets, like here. And the potentiometer must be mounted last, because that is, as you can see, the one with the highest profile. In this case we have a LED, a blue colored LED and a red colored LED. And there's also the yellow one that is an indicator of disk activity or disk emulation activity. Apart from the components here, you will also see that there is this micro SD card with it, and there's three bags with modules that are to be fitted on the board. And when you unpack these bags, you will find these three modules, which is this red one is the TTL USB adapter. There is also the TF card, where you can see here you have to fit in the micro SD card into it. And the micro SD card is already programmed to contain the disk contents. And this one, the latter one, is the real-time clock. So, and before you attach it to the computer, you must be noting the orientation of the modules. This one is like this. The clock is also on the same side, and the terminal adapter board is in the other direction, like this one. And here goes the micro USB cable into it, and that you can connect to the computer for the terminal emulation. On the brochure you will find also the address where all the documentation can be found on my GitHub page. And when you start it first, you will see the boot menu. And you must remember that when you press one of the choices on the boot menu, it will remember that. And the next time that you start it up, it will automatically load that operating system into your board. And in order to return to the boot menu, you have to start the computer with the user LED pushed, and then press the reset button like this one, and the boot menu will come up again. That's the first introduction. Further, it's important to set the right terminal settings in the computer. I used mostly PuTTY as the terminal emulator program, and it must be set to 115 kilobaud, 8 bits, no parity, one stop bit, and that should you get started very quickly.